Hello, Brienne.
Hello, I'm Chloe.
I know that you did a emotional healing process with Clinton, I think, about a week ago.
Yes.
Can you report on the change and the effect after that?
Yeah, it has been huge. We unlocked my fear. That I had a really big block with my fear. And even ever since then, and also I had an emotional healing process yesterday that really my fear is so present with me. And I feel so glad because I'm not afraid of it anymore. And it's there 100% of the time. And during the day, I find myself checking like where is my fear, and then there it is, and feeling glad that it's there and that I can listen to what it's about. And yeah, so that has been really different.
Cool.
And I've been doing this ongoing experiment that Clinton suggested, to do three screams twice a day for like 2 weeks, and that has been so just so nice.
Want to do one now?
Yeah.
Okay,
Yeah.
go. Great, that was fantastic. Looking forward to be in a space where I don't have to do that with a cloth in my mouth, because I love feeling fear. And I did a process yesterday, and it was about fear, and I had to have a cloth in my mouth just for the noise here. And so I'm looking forward to having a space where it can just be out. Yeah.
Yeah, and hearing it is really powerful.
Yeah. Cool. Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
So what about today? What can I do for you now, actually?
There's something about my sadness that I can't access it. And maybe we can go there. And there's another. I also have this emotional fear of being authentic, like being fully real and being myself.
So about the sadness, I've seen you be sad. I've seen you cry. So what does this really, where is this coming from?
It's coming from the sense that I can't access it during the day. Like it's more a reactive sadness that comes from emotion, and even doing a 333, it's like nothing comes.
Okay. Well, I would go with the second option, because it's probably related to also your sadness and the authenticity of your sadness. So you said that you can't be authentic, or can you say it again?
Yeah, I'm afraid of being fully authentic.
Can you say more about that? Like, what do, how? Like, what does it mean?
It's like if I'm fully authentic, then I don't even know what I'm gonna say. Like, I don't even know what's gonna come out. I can't predict it. I can't. And my box wants to know what I'm going to say so that I can control it.
what's so great about being able to control it?
About being safe, being like, nobody can, if I can control it, then I can make it so that people don't feel or don't have reaction to what I say.
Okay, so if you're authentic, then people will have reaction.
Yeah.
What kind of reaction?
Anger. They'll be angry.
So if you're authentic, people will be angry at you or around you or about you.
Yeah.
What's the problem with people being angry at you?
I don't know what to do with it. It's like.
You just swallowed a feeling, Brianne.
Yeah, I feel sad. I feel sad about it because.
Okay, just close your eyes. Yeah, and let the feeling come up.
They're gonna hurt me.
Yeah. If you're authentic, then they will hurt you. Yeah, you're doing great. Let the feeling come up. This has happened before, probably more than once.
Yeah. They're coming with a knife. Someone with a knife.
Yes. Someone is coming with a knife.
It's my brother.
Thank you. Do you have a brother in this life?
Yeah.
Did it happen in this life?
It's not him this time.
But it's your brother. But it's not the one. It's not the one that you have in this life.
No.
Okay. You're doing great. Is it nighttime or daytime?
Daytime.
Are you inside or outside?
Outside.
Is it a place you know or a place you don't know?
It's a place I know.
Where is it? Outside.
There's a well and.
Yes.
And like a cottage house or like a country house, but there is nothing else.
There's woods. Is it your house?
I think it's his house.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's happening?
I don't understand what's happening. He's coming at me with a knife and he's gonna kill me. I'm scared he's gonna kill me.
Let the fear get big, Brianne. Yes, that. Yes. Yes. He's coming at you. He has a knife. It seems like he's gonna come and kill you.
I have to run. I have to run away.
Do you run? You say, I have to run. Do you run?
Yes.
You run.
I start running. And he doesn't follow me.
Okay.
And I feel sad because it's my brother and I love him so much and I don't understand.
Yes.
I don't understand how he could come at me with a knife like that.
Yeah.
And I feel anger. I feel confused.
You feel angry because?
I feel angry because what I said, it was so real. And to me, there's the response would not have been to want to hurt me. Like I feel angry because he tried to hurt me.
Rhiannon, click your clicker. Go back to the moment where you said this thing. You say, I'm angry because what I said was real, was so real. Click your clicker. Go back to the moment where you're speaking. Tell me where you are.
We're in the house.
Yes.
And
is it just you and him?
Yeah. And I'm talking about.
Don't say I'm talking about. Say what you're saying. What are you saying?
Saying.
You have your brother. Your brother's in front of you.
So, something. There's this power. This practice I'm doing, and with other people, and we're. It's like magic. We're using magic in. I'm sharing about it. And
Brienne, don't tell me as if you're looking at the scene. You're telling me as if you're looking at the scene instead of being there. What were you feeling? What was your experience when you were sharing this with your brother?
I felt so much aliveness and joy and sharing that
yes,
we're doing this practice and it's so wonderful, and we're in a group of people and we're coming together to empower ourselves, and I want you to join us. I want you to come with me and be there with us, and
yes, and
it's so great, and I want you to be part of it.
Because
I love you. I want yes. you to be part of it because I love you. Because I want you to experience this aliveness and this wonderful magic that we're doing together. And then I want you with me. I want him with me.
You want him with you.
And then he starts getting really angry.
What does he say? Tell me what he says.
He says it
with the voice, with the tone of it, with the whole thing.
What you're saying is the heretism, is the devil worshiping, and is dangerous, and I want you out of here. Get out of this house. I don't want your devil worship around here. And
I think it was louder than that. I think it was louder than that.
What you're talking about is heretism. This is devil worshiping that you're doing with these people. They're brainwashing you. You need to leave this house. I don't want your devil worshiping in this house. You need to get out. Get out. Get out of my house. Yes. Get out. You and your devil worshiping. Get out of here.
Come back to you. Come back to you. He's shouting at you. Get out. Get out. You're a devil worshiper. I want you out of my life. I want you out of my house.
It breaks my heart.
Yeah.
Ha ha ha.
what happens next.
I feel fear. He grabs a knife and I'm so afraid. So I go out and I try to talk to him outside.
Yes.
And
what do you say outside?
It's not devil worshiping. It's something else. You're misunderstanding me.
You're trying to explain yourself.
Yeah. I'm trying to.
You try to be sensible. You're trying to explain what it is really.
I'm trying to translate it to put it in something he would get. That, yes. It's like I modify what I would say if I was just speaking from my aliveness. I make it different so that he can receive it.
Yeah.
And yeah. It doesn't work anyway.
Yeah.
And he keeps saying, go away, leave. I don't want you around here. He keeps saying those things. And then he lunges for me and I have to run. I have to run. I leave. I run. I run away.
Yes. When that happens, Brianne, what do you decide?
I decided I have to change my message. I have to change the way I say things so that people can get it.
Yeah.
And then I feel dead. I feel dead inside.
Yeah. Yeah,
because I'm not doing both anymore. I'm not like speaking from the aliveness and then translating it. I'm just speaking from this robot trying to understand what they would understand and saying it in their words with their mind, and it's not me.
Yeah, you decided to be completely adaptive. Completely adaptive to their language, their memes, their way of experiencing life or not experiencing life.
Yeah.
And you killed your own aliveness in the process.
Yeah.
You shut it down. How did you shut it down? How did you shut down this aliveness that was pouring through you?
I put on this mask. I make my face be blank. And I stuff the aliveness down. I stuff it down.
You stuff it down all the way down to your hips, like,
yeah.
How do you stuff it down? Where, so you have a mask, you put on a mask that is blank face, no emotions, no, doesn't anything, it's dead, it's a dead face. Yeah. Mask.
Yeah.
Like a ghost.
And then, yeah, and I hold it like I notice myself. Okay, I'm very aware of not moving my face.
Okay, but then you made another movement. You put on the face mask, and then what else?
Then there's stuffing the feelings, stuffing the aliveness down.
How do you there? I've, what is how do you do it? What did you put in there?
Yeah, I filled myself with this cement. Like, I filled myself with this heavy gray nothingness, and it just, not even nothing, it's just like this dense
cement.
Yeah.
It's like heavy gray dance dead.
Yeah.
Dead.
And then I put that in everywhere, and then there's like this small space for the aliveness at the, like, in my center.
Okay. But it can come through, because all the tubes, you filled all your energetic body in the tubes of, like, for example, the feelings or the impulses or your connection with Gaia or the connection with magic, the connection with the universe, the connection with your different chakras, with your solar plexus, with your sexual chakra, with your root chakra, which is connection to Gaia. All of that is filled. You filled it in that moment with heavy gray dense cement, dead.
Yes.
So that I can
live, so that I can keep the people that I love around me.
Yeah.
So that nobody hurts me.
Can you say the last thing again?
So that nobody hurts me.
Yes. Yeah. I think also so that you can control. So you can control what comes out.
Yeah. I can use my mind.
Yeah.
To this side. Like, there's this like scanning thing happening of my mind and also energetically, like, what is acceptable? Like, what do people understand? What is the thought where in this room that I can just connect to? And then just speaking from there.
So you're not there, Brianne. No. When you do that, which is ongoing all the time, you're not there. Yeah. And it's this show, this dead face mask and your mind that gives people what they want. Your life is about giving people what they want.
Yeah, if I give them what they want, then they'll leave me alone. They won't kill me.
Yeah. They won't threaten you with a knife or tell you to leave. I want to check something. After you ran away from your brother's house, you're running away and you made these decisions and you put in these blocks. What happened next?
I ran to the house I live in and I was just pretending like nothing happened.
So you made also, it's like a decision, it's like a meme. Nothing happened.
Yeah. Nothing happened.
My brother tried to kill me and nothing happened.
I never saw him again either, my brother. I never saw him.
Did you see your group of practice again?
I didn't go. I was scared that other people would think the same thing my brother did. That they would also try to kill me.
Yeah. If you kept going, if you met them again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I miss them so much. I miss being with my group and practicing with them and the aliveness and I missed my brother and everything is just dead after that.
No. How did you reconcile in yourself? I mean, I get that you put the cement and everything and the mask. You put the cement and the mask. But when you went back home and you said, I'm not going to go see my group anymore, what did you decide about them or about the practice?
I decided my brother was probably right. His problem.
So that what? He was right about?
About it being bad. It's bad. It's devil worship. But there is still a part of me that... that felt so connected to it and the love and the aliveness and longing for that. And that part never believed that it was bad. But it's like I was pretending that it was bad so that I could keep the show going.
It's part of the show. Yeah. It's part of the show that it... So what is bad?
This getting together with people to practice magic is bad.
Yeah. That would be in conflict, that you would have to pretend that for the world. That would be in huge conflict, for example, in your presence in the mage training. It's bad. And actually, it seems to say that you say it's also dangerous, because if you're there, then other people might try to kill you. Can you say it in your own words? Getting together with people, practicing magic.
Getting together with people to, with other mages to practice magic is gonna get me killed.
Yeah.
And there's this whole thing, like, I have to keep it secret.
Yeah.
That I'm there.
It's huge, Brianne. I mean, this conversation we had on Tuesday about You thinking there's 10 people who know about your mage. It's this. You know, I have to keep it secret. To play dead. To be cemented. So then I can control. Then I can keep the people I love around me. They won't try to kill me or go away or tell me to go away. Your whole life then has been dedicated, I mean, your whole lives since then has been dedicated to what can they handle? What do they want? Actually, it's not even what they can handle, is what do they want? What do they want to hear from me?
Yeah.
This ongoing scanner out there.
I'm sick of it. I'm so fucking tired of it.
Okay, you're tired of it. You're sick of it.
I'm sick of pretending this fucking cement thing. I don't want to be dead anymore.
Okay. The thing is, when you say I'm sick of it and I'm tired of it, it's a victim story. And you're a victim of your own survival strategy. But it was smart. Brianne, when you put that thing on, the mask, and when you put the cement in, you didn't have any, it's like that was the, it was a life or death. It was literally a life or death situation. Your brother was gonna kill you with a knife, maybe other people. That was the best thing that you discovered back then. That was the best thing you could, so you could keep living. You decided to keep living. But you were dead. You decided to keep living by killing your aliveness. You can make another choice. You can change your mind today. Why would it be different? If you take out the cement and you take out the mask and you connect back to your aliveness, it's going to be different. Your life will be different. How is that for you? How are you going to handle it? You've learned some stuff. You've learned a lot of stuff.
I'm going to grieve the people that need to go. That they can't stay around. I want to grieve them. I want to let them go.
Okay. I want to give you a hint about that, about people coming and going. Is you can trust Echo. You can radically rely on the Earth Coincidence Control Office to move the people around you, because it's doing that for everybody. And basically, it's not really, you don't get to decide, but you can radically rely on Echo that it's moving people around for like evolution, for serving the purpose of Gaia, let's say. And so it basically kind of has nothing to do with you in terms of, you know, being a good person, being a bad person, being lovable or not lovable. It has nothing to do with that. You can radically rely on Echo. What else?
there's this big sense of fear that comes up.
Yes.
When I think about taking the mask off in this cement, and it's about using the fear to be careful and to be like authentic, but to be like, to be careful and to use my sadness and take the time and to be present and to slow it down and to spread my aliveness with the joy and to just stand for it with my anger.
Yes. Your fear will help you to not be naive. In a way, when you went to see your brother, you were naive.
Yeah.
And you were all heart open and, you know, this whole aliveness. But in a way, you didn't have your sort of clarity. You didn't have your anger, where you could also make boundaries. You did not make a boundary with your brother. No, that is not okay. Break his nose, basically, that's the boundary. Break his nose. You know, if he comes in, is aggressive with you.
Yeah.
And the fear is this, as you say, it's this like, it's this being careful, not being naive.
Yeah.
And the sadness is also for connecting. I mean, you know, you wanted your brother in the practice group. And you say, because you love him. You know, you wanted him with you. But in a way, that's very selfish.
Yeah.
Because it's about you. It's about you love him. You want him.
Yeah.
Instead of, okay, what does he want? What's best for him? And that's the sadness. That's the, you can connect and just people are where they are. Yeah. Okay. I propose that we start by taking out the cement. It's going to be loud. It's going to be painful. Have you ever seen, have you ever seen pictures or movies of people who are like stuck in cement?
No.
Okay. The cement takes away all the nutrients out of the body. It takes all the water. It takes all the, it drains out everything. So you've had that for a long time in your energetic body. And also it has done its work in other bodies. It has drained out the aliveness and the impulses and the resources. So when you're going to pull it out, it's going to hurt. Okay. You make a black hole and you just put it down the black hole.
Okay.
Take your hands, put it on your body and it's going to automatically find it. Yes. 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 Keep going, Brianna. Yes. Yes. This is just the superficial layers. Yes, keep going. Yes, and the coughing. Let the coughing get bigger. Yeah, pull it out of there too. Yes. Yes. Ah! Yes, next layer. Go all the way deep, all the way deep in. Put your fingers right in there. Yes. Yes. Yes, Brianne, behind the coughing. Brianne, behind the coughing, there's a sound. Let the coughing get bigger and let the sound out. Yes. 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 Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Keep pulling the cement. Keep pulling it out. Yes. 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 Yes, that was fantastic. There's more deeper layers. It's in every of your tubes. It's in your tubes of anger. It's in your tubes of fear, of sadness, and of joy, and your connection with Gaia. Just, it's everywhere. Yes. 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 Yes, there too. Yes, yes, yeah. Yeah, pull it out in the black hole. Yeah. Yes. 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 You're doing great. Next layer. Grab. Try to put your hands all the way deep inside. Good. Put all the way deep inside. Yes. Yes, there too. That's your solar plexus. That's where your creativity, your aliveness, your connection to the universe. This is yes. 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 It's huge. Yes. Yes. Yeah, in the black hole, Brianne, in the black hole. Close that black hole and make a new one. Take your hands next layer, wherever it is. Yes. Yes. Yes, right there. Yes. Make the sound, yes. It sounds like there's also words. If there's words, just say the words. Yes. Yes, get out. Yes. Check it out. It seems to me that there's some left. It seems around your heart still, and on in your pelvic floor, because you pressed all it down. It's in down there. It's sort of sedimented down there. Yeah. There's a huge plaque there. Yeah. Yes, Brianne, yes. Yes, let the sounds out. Yes. Next layer, there's bigger sound than that, Brianne. There's really bigger sound. Yes. Yes. Use your anger to pull it out. Yes. Yes, close the black hole, open a new one. Just check again with your hands, like all over, like even your from the your neck, your shoulders, there might be some little, just some little left. Just grab the little pieces left and just throw them in the black hole. And if it's a big one, grab it too. Yes. Yeah. Yes. 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 Yes, 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 all the way. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Get out! Get
yes, keep out! Keep going, keep going.
Get out! Get out!
Yes, yes, right there. Yeah. Yeah. You're getting your voice back, Brianne. You're getting your voice back. Yes. That was great. That was really great. I want you to grab, you have a healing cream. You have an energetic shelf that lives with you. And on there's a healing cream. Just grab it and open it, open the lid. What color is it?
White.
White. You take big handfuls. And you put it everywhere, everywhere where there was cement. Slowly, Brianne, this is way too fast. This is the speed of your mind. Your body has been in cement, been drained out of all its energy for this long. And now it's kind of raw. It's like back, it has back to, like having access to resources and to aliveness. and to the air around it, to the love around it, the joy of it. You helping it like heal. It's like being burnt. Having cement around is like being burnt. Putting some cream. Just talk to your bodies, okay? Are you doing this? Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you for what?
Thank you for being there. Thank you for supporting me. Thank you for
waiting. Thank you for waiting for me all this time. I put you through torture, and you're still there.
Yeah, I put you through torture. Thank you for waiting all this time for me to come and take care of you. Thank you for waiting.
Big handfuls, Brianne. Be really, really generous with yourself. It's something that it's new for you. You don't really know how to do that, really. To be generous with yourself. For no reason. For no reason. Not because you deserve it. Not because whatever. Yeah.
Thank you.
Tell them I want you. I want you because I need you because
I want you because I want you and I need you because I want to be fully alive. I want to
Brianne, say this. I want you because I am fully alive.
I want you because I am fully alive.
And you are the vessel. Like you are you giving me the information.
And you are the vessel. You're giving me the information.
Of this aliveness. You're my connection with Gaia. You're my connection with other people. Yes.
You're my connection with Gaia. You're my connection with people. I want you. I need you because I want to be, because I am connected to Gaia. I am connected to people.
And I am connected to myself. You are my connection with myself.
You are my connection with myself. You're my connection with myself.
Take a big handful for your heart, Brianne. Take another big handful for your heart. Yes. Slowly, 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 slowly. Yes. Right in there. Push a little bit. Yes. Yes. I've missed you.
I missed you. I missed you. Thank you for waiting.
Yes.
I'm here now.
Yes. Take it. Yeah. When you're ready, you can also take a big handful for your solar plexus, really. Because you're such a creative being, Brianne. Yeah. Yeah. So much was stuck there. It was stuck.
Yeah. Thank you for waiting. I missed you.
What does it say? Connect with it. What does it say?
It says I'm here.
Yeah.
Thank you for waiting.
You're doing great, Brianne. Take another handful and just check like places that you haven't put creams on yet.
Put this one to my pelvic floor.
Yes. Yeah. So much of your feminine, you know, your feminine powers is there. And a particular connection with Gaia as being a feminine being. So much force. Like raw aliveness. Yeah. Raw aliveness is there. When you're ready, just close the cream. Stay with yourself. Stay with your five body. Is there more places? I didn't ask. Is there more places? Okay.
No.
Okay, just close the cream, put it back on the shelf. It's an unlimited cream. It's one of those kinds that you don't have to spend money for. You still have the mask on. This dead face mask. I want you, when you're gonna take it off, you don't put it down the black hole. Okay. We didn't really talk about this. When you started pulling out the cement, I thought that I don't know if that's going to be really something that somebody else wants, or somebody else that something that you would want to give somebody else, because the cement is kind of a torture chamber, really. But the mask, somebody else might need it to survive.
Yeah.
So this one, we'll give it to somebody else, okay?
Okay.
While you take off the mask, this is the mask that you put with this, with the decision, I have to change the way I say thing so people can get it, or that people won't leave me. I speak for robots, and then I become a robot, and I'm dead. I kill myself. It's a dead face.
Yeah.
While you take off the mask, what's the new decision? You're going to say the new decision. What's your new decision about this? Because it's a stand to change a decision about being adaptive. You might need to grab a cloth, because it's not going to come from your mind. It's going to come from this energy that you had when you said, I'm sick of it and I'm tired of it. You grab the cloth and put it in your hand. Yeah. Yeah.
It's about showing myself, showing my feelings.
So this is not a philosophical conversation. So it is not about something, is what changes? Who are you? Who are you? You are something different. You are something different. Yes.
I am a mage. I am a mage. I can show myself. I show myself. I show my feelings.
What about if other people get angry? You need to handle this.
Yes. If other people get angry, if other people get angry, I'm in my own bubble. They're in their own bubble. I can even make a black hole. I have all these tools and I can use them. I can use these tools from my tool belt.
Okay, there's some kind of boundary that you need to make with your brother. While you take off the mask, at the same time you're going to take off the mask, what's the boundary with your brother? Say, I've changed my mind. Your brother's in front of you. Said, back then when you threatened me with the knife, I decided I need to change. You tell him what happened. Tell him with force. Goes through his box.
Back then, when you told me that I was doing devil worshiping, I decided to put on a mask so that I would change what I say so I could reach you. I would say what you want to hear. Decided I would say what you want to hear, and I'm changing my mind.
Yeah, go.
I'm changing my mind. I'm not saying what people want to hear anymore. I'm not saying what you want to hear anymore.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that I'm alive. I'm alive. That's what
yes.
I'm alive. This is my aliveness. This is my aliveness. I changed my mind.
I take back my authority. I take back my authority to be alive.
I take back my authority to be alive. I have the authority to be alive.
Yes.
I have the authority to be alive.
And to say what I want.
I have the authority to say what I want.
And to say what's needed.
I have the authority to say what is needed.
And I don't need the mask anymore. And take the mask off.
Take it off.
Yes, the sound. Let the sound be on.
I don't need this mask anymore. I'm alive.
Yes, and hold it in your hand. You can say thank you to the mask. Thank you for saving my life.
Thank you for saving my life.
But I don't need you anymore. I'm taking back my authority.
I don't need you anymore. I'm taking back my authority.
Authority to be alive and to have my face move and my voice move.
My authority to be alive. My authority to have my face move and show my feelings and have my voice change according to my aliveness.
Yes.
I don't need you anymore, but thank you for saving my life.
Yeah, and you say another little, like another girl or boy, it doesn't need to be little, another boy or girl, somebody will need you. Needs you already. It needs you already.
there is another little boy, little girl, or someone else out there that needs your service. There's someone else that needs their life to be saved by you.
I'm letting you go.
So I'm letting you go.
You can try it. Look, you might need to like move your face a bit because it's really been frozen dead. Just like stretch it out a little. Yeah. Rianne, you need to practice the muscle of your forehead because this is the muscle that of anger. If you open your eyes for a while. Just open your. Have all this like forehead muscles. Really, all of these, there are so many muscles on your face. They've been dead.
Yes. Yes.
So you're going to have to. Yeah, you're going to have to practice.
Yeah, I need to do face exercise.
Yes. I needed to do that. I had a dead face also. And I really needed to like practice having all these like forehead muscle, these wrinkles on the nose and like look bad. To really. To look bad. I would practice in front of the mirror. I'd practice with Clinton. Practice with Nicole. She needs also the practice. She also needs the practice. Okay? And the voice, and it's going to sound bad. It's going to sound ugly. It's going to sound whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. See my face. You can vanish your brother. You probably have your brother there. Just vanish him. There's one more thing. There's one more decision that I would like to check with you. It's this thing of about practicing in a group. And it's, you said, getting together with practice is bad and it's gonna get me killed. So I have to keep it a secret. That's the thing, I have to keep it a secret.
Yeah.
What would be your new decision about that?
Really rely on my fear. Really, I'll rely on my fear to share about it in it carefully. To not keep it a secret, but to use my fear consciously to not keep it a secret.
Yeah.
To use my anger to not be adaptive in my desire to like be careful, but to use my anger to take a stand for it and be careful in the way that I unfold the secret.
It's not a secret anymore. It's not, the secret's out. You are out. It's too late. It's actually already too late for you.
Yeah.
So this is just this, it was just hanging around. Just this old decision hanging around, but it's The secret is out. The secret that Brienne Vaillancourt is a mage.
Yeah.
Is out.
Yeah, and yesterday I made a YouTube video. I posted a YouTube video about being a mage, and it's out.
It's out. So you don't have to worry about it. And as you say, use your fear to not, this is not about being confrontational, and it's not about convincing other people. And in a way, that's what you try to do with your brother, and basically his gremlin, who had the job to protect him, attacked you. It was his gremlin. It wasn't your brother.
Yeah.
And so the secret is out because you are that, because you shine it. And so you could keep it a secret with all this cement in and the dead mask and I'm not going to go into the group anymore. Then you can keep it a secret. But now you can't.
Yeah.
Okay. Welcome back.
Yeah.
Welcome back, Mage Brienne Vaillancourt. Yeah. To the game. Yeah. I'm glad.
Yeah, I feel glad too.
I want to share that sadness was also for me the feeling that was the one that I had shut down the most. And so anger came pretty fast, and then fear came pretty fast, and sadness, I'm trying to check like how was it, like what practices I did. And it was like, for example, I'm going to show you. Wait. A few months ago, I got this guy. His name is Gilder. And it was partly because I had moved a lot when I was a kid, and I didn't, I had to leave my, how do you call them? Like peluche?
Yeah.
Teddy bear. Yeah, teddy bears and stuff, like along the way. And I never got to grieve them. And so there's this part of, because I had to move a lot, I didn't learn how to grieve, and I just shut down my sadness. And so I found ways to like open doors like that for my sadness. And I keep doing it even now.
Mm-hmm.
And so I don't, what, and you might have, you know, you, I put blocks. I mean, I want to tell you the story that when I finally started, like this flood of sadness started opening, it was in a training. And then the next day we went to a cafe with Clinton, and I barfed, like there was this, all this like tiny little tissue paper. And I kept having this saliva thing coming up, and I just kept barfing it and putting it. And there was this pile of paper at the cafe, and people were like, Jesus, what's going on with this woman? But anyway, there was like layers of blocks. So yeah. You might need to check like what, you know, is there a block or an old decision about sadness, like sadness is bad, or I can't be sad, I need to be strong, like stuff like that.
Yeah.
But what would be a practice to start having this connection? What could you do? Or
I think is the 333, like doing it more regularly, the sadness 333.
Okay, but it somehow, you know, there's a way that anger, you can have the towel and, you know, let the anger come in. And the fear, when you get access to it, you know, you just fall into it, just like you did in the beginning, and you have those big scream. And the sadness is also one of these falling in process. You can't push sadness.
Mm-hmm.
And so what would be the, the connector, like the an object, or yeah, it would be better if it was an object that would create this connection with your sadness.
I have this sense that it could also be for me like a teddy bear or a small blanket, something. Okay.
Do you have that, or would you need to go get one somewhere?
I'd have to get one.
Okay. So would you do that in the next, like even today or tomorrow, like in the next 3 days?
Yeah.
Great. And then when you do the 333, just like really cuddle in and even talk to that thing. And, yeah. And maybe it will be, in the beginning, it will be emotional sadness, and it's fine. It's fine. You need to, it's just like the other feeling. You start where you shut down your sadness. So it might be you might have a memory of a teddy bear that you lost, or you might have a memory of a pet that you mm-hmm. lost, or of a really precious girlfriend that somehow you stopped talking to each other, or, and just, so in that blanket is this interface somehow. Yeah. And it just creates this connection, and yeah.
Yeah.
Great.
I will do that.
Anything else right now?
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you for navigating with me.
You're welcome. And practice, okay? With your screams, you know, two times a day, you're like, yes. Oh, the sound. You want it. The goal is to have wrinkles early on, okay? Because it's like placid magazine picture. It's like they're dead face. So they're really, we have a lot of good example for dead face, and just like try to make yourself wrinkles, like smiling wrinkles. Yeah, that's the goal. Okay. Have fun with that.
Yeah. Bye. Bye, Anne-Chloé.